Dear students, now let me discuss about representation of vectors by using coordinate. Here, coordinate means we have discussed these topics into two parts. One is two dimensional case and other is three dimensional case. Now, the first one is for the two dimensional plane or two dimensional plane. Here we have x and y axis only. This is x axis and this is our y axis. Now let me take a point P on this two dimensional plane. So the coordinate of this point is x, y. So for this point, we have to go x along the x axis, the distance x along the x axis, and y along the y axis. So this will be x and this will be y. Now the position vector of this P with respect to O will be like this. This is R vector. Now, if this line has the magnitude x, then the vector along this x axis will be x I hat, and the vector along the y axis will be y j hat. As you may know that I hat and j hat are the unit vector along the x as well as along the y direction. So here from this triangle OPQ, we can find from the triangle law that R equals to xi hat plus yj hat. So this vector R can be represented in terms of x and y, that is by using coordinate, that is xi hat plus yj hat. Now as xi hat and yj hat are perpendicular to each other, the magnitude of this R will be nothing but coefficient of I hat square x square plus the coefficient of j hat square, that is y square. So here R equals to x square plus y square. Similarly, if we want to know the direction of this vector, which is making an angle theta with the x axis, then this tan theta will be from this triangle, you can easily find out tan theta is nothing but pi divided by x. So here, this is the representation of the vector, the position vector R, in terms of x and y. That is the representation of vectors by using the coordinates in two dimensional plane. Now, if we have two points on a two dimensional plane, then we can also easily find out the distance between these two points by using the vector concept, which you have seen in your mathematics class earlier. Now we like to derive the formula for distance between two points by using this formula. If this is our x axis and this is our y axis, and this is point P, which has the coordinate x1, y1, and this is the point Q, which has the position x2, y2. Let the position vector of this P is nothing but R1, and the position vector of Q is R2, and the position vector of Q with respect to P is nothing but R1, 2. Now by using the triangle law, we can find out that R1 plus R12 equals to R2. So R1 plus R12 is nothing but R2. Now we have to find out R12. So R12 is equal to R2 vector minus R1 vector. Now what is R1 and what is R2? R1 is nothing but x1 I hat. R1 is nothing but x1 I hat plus y1 j hat, and R2 is nothing but x2 I hat plus y2 j hat. So if we substitute these values here, then we will get R12 is equals to x2 I hat plus y2 j hat minus x1 I hat plus y1 j hat. That will be x2 minus x1 I hat plus y2 minus y1 j hat. So the magnitude of this vector R12, that is the distance between, perpendicular distance between these two points P and Q, is the magnitude of R12. So R12 mod is equal to nothing but root coefficient of I hat square, that is x2 minus x1 whole square, plus the coefficient of j hat square, that is y2 minus y1 whole square. So as you know from your previous classes, that the distance between two points is nothing but x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 square. Now the same formulas we have to prove in the case of three dimensional space. So now let me discuss that on three dimensional space, that is 3D space. Here in this case we have three axes, as you know. One is x axis, another is y axis. This is taken as x axis, this is y axis, and this is z axis. And suppose that here is a particle P, a point P, which has the coordinate x, y, j. Now, if we want to get this point P, then we have to go x along this direction, then y, and then z. So, this vector will be xi hat, this vector will be yj hat, and this vector will be zk hat. So, the position vector of P with respect to point O will be in this direction, that is OP. Now, if we talk about the position vector OP, that is the vector R, then the R will be the resultant of xi, yj, and zk. So, by using the polygon law, we can easily write down that R vector is nothing but xi hat plus yj hat plus zk hat. Now, what is the magnitude of this R? If we draw a line over here, then from the previous case we know that the distance of this, of the length of this line will be root, as this is xi hat, this is yj hat, and this will be root x square plus y square. This is a triangle. Now from this triangle we can also get this R square will be this square plus this square. So R square will be nothing but root x square plus y square whole square plus z square. So R square will be x square plus y square plus z square. So R will be root x square plus y square plus z square. So when there is a two-dimensional case, then in that case we have x square plus y square. And for three-dimensional case, when we have a zk hat, then we have x square plus y square plus z square. Now we have to find the direction of this vector R, that is the vector making an angle alpha with the x axis, beta with the y axis, and let gamma with the z axis. And please keep in mind, I take only the magnitude of all these angles, not the direction. Okay, so this angle is alpha, this angle is beta, this angle is gamma. So in that case, we have to find out this alpha, beta, and gamma also. So for this purpose, let me draw the figure in an alternative way, like let us consider this is our x axis, this is our y axis, and this is our z axis, and this is the vector R. So this R vector making an angle alpha with the x axis, and this vector R making an angle beta with the y axis, and this vector R making an angle gamma with the z axis. So now if you draw a perpendicular over here, and as we know, this is x I hat, this is y j hat along the y axis, and this is z k hat, which is along the z axis. So from this figure we can easily write down that cos alpha is nothing but x divided by r, cos beta is nothing but y divided by r, this y divided by r, and cos gamma is nothing but z divided by r. And this will be in the L. This is M and this is M, and this L, M, N are nothing but direction cosine of the vector. Direction cosine of the vector. Now, if we square this L, M, and N and then add, we will get always 1. That is, L square plus M square plus M square will always give unity. That is, L square plus M square plus M square will be x square by R square plus y square by r square plus z square by r square. That will be nothing but x square plus y square plus z square divided by r square. That will be r square divided by r square equals to 1. So always n square plus n square plus n square will give you unity. Now, like previous case, if we have to find out the distance, the perpendicular distance between two points, In that case, in three-dimensional case, we have also x, y, z, and this is the P point, which is the coordinate x1, y1, z1, and this is the Q point, which has the coordinate x2, y2, z2. This vector has the position vector r1, and this has the position vector r2, and this vector has the position vector q with respect to p, that is r1. And we know that r1 from the previous case is nothing but r2 minus r1, and if we substitute the value of r2 and r1, so what is r2? R2 is nothing but x2 I hat plus y2 j hat plus z2 k hat. And what is r1? R1 is nothing but x1 I hat plus y1 j hat plus z1 k. Now if we substitute the value here, then we will get r12 is nothing but x2 minus x1 I hat plus y2 minus y1 j hat plus z2 minus z1 k hat. So mod r12 will be what? Will be root x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square plus z2 minus z1 whole square. Okay? Thank you.